Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman and members of the committee. Before I begin my testimony, please allow me a moment to express my appreciation to you, Chairman Goss, and you, Ranking Member Dix, for your efforts and those of your colleagues on the House Permanent Select Committee of Intelligence to wade through the morass of allegations stemming from press reports of the Central Intelligence Agency's involvement in drug trafficking in South Central Los Angeles. I would especially like to acknowledge my Southern California colleagues on the committee, Congress members Jerry Lewis, Julian Dixon, and Jane Harmon, as well as Congressional Black Caucus Chairwoman Maxine Waters and California Delegation Co-Chairwoman Lucille Raubal-Allard. Their support of my efforts to give voice to the concerns of my constituents in the immediate aftermath of the controversial press reports alleging CIA wrongdoing was encouraging and meant a great deal to me and the residents of California's 37th Congressional District. Mr. Chairman and committee members, I commend the chairman for fulfilling his commitment to hold this hearing. Like the chairman, I too was deeply disturbed by the allegations as reported in the San Jose Mercury News in August of 1996 of the Central Intelligence Agency's involvement in the introduction, financing, and distribution of crack cocaine in the 1980s. Consequently, I contacted administration officials, the appropriate leaders of the House of Representatives, and even the former UN Secretary General to ask their respective organizations to look into these allegations. I also wrote to the mayors of major urban cities, many of whom responded by confirming that their cities witnessed a significant increase in drug trafficking and proliferation of cocaine use and abuse during the same time period. On September 11th, I introduced House Resolution 518 to establish a special select committee to look into these allegations. I did so, Mr. Chairman, not with any intent to slay the permanent select committee, but because I believe the persistence of issues raised by this and other controversies about the CIA's accountability, the agency's ability to investigate itself, the public's desire and need for the truth, and the agency's mission in a post-Cold War world require much broader congressional involvement in these important proceedings. As many of you are aware, I convened two town hall meetings in the fall of 1996. In response to the widespread feelings of anxiety, public outrage, and concern throughout my district, in the wake of news accounts which seemed to implicate the CIA in drug trafficking in the early and mid-1980s in South Central Los Angeles and urban America. The first town hall meeting at Compton Community College on October 19, 1996, was attended by hundreds of residents from my drug-ravaged community. The purpose of the Compton Congressional Inquiry was to educate myself and other members of Congress about the specific issues raised by allegations of U.S. government involvement in and knowledge of drug trafficking in South Central Los Angeles. I also sought out how the local community responded to the widespread harm caused by the scourge of substance abuse, regardless of the source or cause, and allowed them to seek answers to these allegations. I invited the Justice Inspector General Michael Bromwich to come and meet with leaders and members of the community so that they could express their concerns. Mr. Bromwich observed the proceedings of the Congressional Inquiry and took notes with a number of panelists testifying, including Ricky Ross's mother and Ricky Ross himself, via telephone from the San Jose Detention Center. On November 15th, in response to my invitation, then Director of Central Intelligence, John Dorch, made an unprecedented visit to Allen Locke High School in the Watts section of my district to directly address the concerns raised by my constituents and me, generated by these allegations during a public town hall meeting.